Hey everybody, it's MikeD57S here, and I am going to do something a little different today. Yeah, I recently just been thinking of what other videos I can do on my spare time, and since I'm on my spare time, well, I was bored, I had to think of something, and, well, here it is. Yep, I decided I am going to do a review on magazines. Yeah, these Thomas the Tank Engine magazines. Yes. Now, I've been pondering on what kind of videos I will do in due time, like in terms of the other planned videos I have for 2017, and here they are. These are, these Thomas and Friends magazines, and you want to know something else is that, I just want to get the barcode out of the way, I don't want you guys to, something else I never told you is that, I've had these magazines for years. Yes, you guys, I've had these magazines for so many years on my bookshelf in my room, and I just never told you about this. Yeah, like, I just forgot about them all these years. But then the thought just hit me. It's been a while since I've looked at them, and I thought it would be quite rare if I just showed you them on YouTube, because I remember as a child, you know, in my youth, as a Thomas fan, that I loved collecting these. Like, my grandma and, of course, my step-grandfather, yeah. Yes, like, my grandmother would always, like, buy me these books when I was, like, 4, 5, or 6, well, yeah, around this, because these were from the early 2000s, yeah. Both of these issues you see right here were, but both of them were released in 2001, like this one was, let's see, oh yes, as you can see here, alright, this one was released in February of March 2001, and it even says volume 3, as you can see right over there, and this one was released in April of May of the same year, so yeah, these were pretty cool, like, just to know. But just one other thing to point out is that Thomas magazines have been sold ever since, like, what was it? Oh, yeah, they were sold back in the 80s. I think it was 1987, I think it was. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was that year. But I've never had, you know, yes, I've never had, you know, any of the earlier, you know, magazine stories from the 80s and the 90s. I only had them from the early 2000s. So, yes, I was about, like, 4 or 5 when I had these magazines, as you can see right here. Though I don't exactly know where my grandma bought them. Like, I can't exactly remember the name of, say, the store, but I know it had to be somewhere where they do sell magazines, especially old ones, I think. Because I also remember getting 2 more issues, which would have been, you know, released, you know, in later years. I think in 2004 or 2005. Yeah, like, I remember getting these when I was 9 years old and such. And they've been around, and I've had these for a while, so I thought it would be a good idea to show these, as Thomas magazines could be, well, actually, they still sell Thomas magazines right now, you know, due to the popularity of the modern series. This was back, you know, just for the classic series, and they are a rare sight, and so, yeah, you be, and these, of course, were for children, really. So, yes, before we get on, something else to point out is that each of the magazines that were released even had, like, their own theme. Yeah, because these were, of course, kids' magazines, as you know. Let's see. This one is about hot and cold. And this one is about delays. So, yeah. And, of course, being a guy that likes going through time chronologically, I will, like, go through this one first, the hot and cold one, which you can see right here. Oh, and yes, something else is that here is the people that released this. They're called, here it is, Redan, let me just get it closer. Redan Fun to Learn, yes, as seen on TV. I could assume that Thomas was still on PBS at the time. I don't really know that for sure, but yes. Alright, so this was by Redan Fun to Learn magazines. I don't know the other kind of, like, shows that they ever, you know, did. So far, I think Thomas is the one they did so far. Alright, so let's get started. Alright, so, yes, these, here is the table of contents. As we will go through so far, and now, of course, these were really good, as This, of course, like I said, both of them were released in 2001, and this came out at a time when Thomas was still at the height of its popularity with the classic season. Yes, the classic. Like, look, I know many of you Railway Series fans are going to disagree with me on that, because you guys care mostly about the books and are not really into the original ideas, but come on, Thomas was still popular, even if it was after a year later when Thomas and the Magic Railroad, you know, became a flop at the box office. Alright, so here is the first magazine story, and excuse the light. Yes, there's this stupid glare in my basement. Alright, this one is called Chili Diesel, and, like, this one, of course, revolves around Diesel just being pissed off at the steam engines, you know, for their fires and such. Typical Diesel. And this, of course, you know, seeing that this was in no continuity at all with the Railway series, Diesel is a permanent member on the Northwestern for some strange reason, and interacting with Thomas when it should have been Percy, yeah. As for the artwork in these magazines, they're alright. I mean, they're likable. I do like, you know, the way they were drawn. They're not really, like, the best, say, if you want the Owen Bell artwork from the 80s and 90s, but I still think that they're really good to look at, for the most part. So yeah, each story, like, these magazine stories would have, like, a number next to them, like, in a different, like, paragraph, and a different, like, picture next to them, too. So this one, of course, would revolve around Thomas helping Diesel, and something else is, seeing that this is a kids' magazine, they'd also, like, would have... They'd also have, like, these short little, like, questions, like, on counting questions and such. Yeah, Look, I was a kid back then, and these are kids' magazines. Though, kids are a lot smarter than that, but I digress, I guess. Oh, and look at this. There's Percy, and what did you know? He actually has a scarf. Never mind the... Of course, a little reference to Percy in the Trousers, or a scarf for Percy, as it was called. Why did they change the whole story? Ah! And here's another one with, Here's another picture, with, like, just answering, like, an I Spy little game. Like, it just, yeah, most of these questions, they're pretty obvious. And I'm not kidding, they're very obvious. Like, for example, is Thomas pulling Annie or Clarabelle? Yes, it's Annie, but of course Clarabelle's behind. And who is coming through the tunnel? And there's Henry. Oh, and I see they even have the same style of snowplow, yeah. Yes, do you think it's hot or cold? It's obviously, yes, get used to this, guys. Most of the questions, seeing that this, of course, is a kids' magazine, they're pretty obvious as you go along. So yeah, they have other kind of questions. Oh, and something else is this little thing that I did when I was a kid. Yes, you basically would cut out the snowplow, like you could see right here, and paste it onto Thomas, and then you also cut out these snowflakes and paste them right anywhere you want, really. And there we have Edward, James, Percy. And here's something else that you're not going to believe. Help Thomas and his conductor. Or guard, as you would. Yeah, that's very inaccurate, because it's the driver that usually does. Yeah, like, help Thomas and his driver. I don't know what they were thinking, but here's something else you wouldn't believe. Rather than that little, like, writing error, Thomas and his conductor, really? Alright, here's something else you're not gonna believe. Here, you even cut out the snowplow and the snowflakes, but it's also pretty stupid, because what also made these, like, special, like, what made these, like, magazines special is that they even have a poster of, like, a certain, like, picture from the actual, from the actual series. But what was stupid is that you actually cut part of the poster because the snowflakes are there. Man. What a real, like, they should have had a little, like, card connected to it. You could rip it out, and then you could cut all the snowflakes and the snowplow out, then paste them. But instead, we have a half-torn poster. As you can see here, we got Thomas. Oh, let me just, show you what the full poster looks like. Yes. Ugh. Sorry about that, guys. Here, I think I got an idea. Alright, There we go. Yes, this poster is for the episode Thomas Gets Bumped, where he's shunting angrily in the yard after, you know, his branch line is out of commission. And here in the yellow packet you see right here is we even got some other little questions and such. It's a workbook, you know, with more obvious children's questions. Yeah, I can tolerate that this is a children's book, but like I said, children are a lot smarter than this. Children, they could be a lot smarter than you think. Okay, yeah, they're rambunctious and such, but yeah, they're rambunctious and, you know, really naive, but they're just still kids, you know? But some of the questions, yeah, I don't know what they would be thinking. So yeah, here we have counting questions, coloring, drawing. Yeah, I drew this. I was young back. I was a kid back then. What'd you expect? And here's something else. Now, let me close in on it. Okay, here it is. This, of course, is the Don't Miss an Issue. Like, these, of course, let's see. If you really want any more, yeah, I think this is for just in case you want any more, like, say, magazines. And it says, great for ages 3 to 8. Yeah, but I'm sure, well, okay, maybe not a 3-year-old. I mean, yes, because preschoolers can definitely answer questions like, I'm sure would have fun with this. I mean, I know I did when I was young, but 8-year-olds, I don't really think so. Yeah, but I doubt this is going to be any good now, seeing, oh, and yeah, here's the mail card. Oh, and here's the other, like, kid shows you got right here. Alright, some of the other kid shows you got, oh, stupid camera. Yeah, just gotta wait for this damn thing to actually take focus right now. Oh, frick. Alright, I think you got it. Alright, some of the other kid shows that they've done are Spot, Macy's, Bear in the Big Blue House, I don't know what this rabbit character is from. No. But we also got Mr. Potato Head and Paddington. Yeah, the Paddington Bear is also involved. Let's close out of this for a second. And we even got Connect the Dots. And again, I was a kid, so you had to draw. Oh, in this case, it's Clarabelle. Yeah, none of, and no Annie. We even got, a reading. We also got a maze game with Birdie the Bus. And we even got a little checklist of any of the activities that you did in the book. And something else that these things come with are fan art. Yeah, these, like, the magazines would also include some fan art that was done by any of the fans from those who would watch them. You know what, I'm going to take this camera off the tripod and actually just show you around. Excuse me for a second. Alright, that's much better. I had to remove the bottom part. Okay, so, yes, the bulletin board would feature, like, fan art that was done by the fans, you know, of Thomas. Well, obviously, because kids, because, you know, these are the kind of artwork that you'd see done by a child. Alright, so here we got, like, here, I'll just, you know, skim through it. I'm not going to explain everything. Plus, these are done by children, like I said. Oh, and it's not just fan art, even pictures of kids, you know, and seeing the collections they have connected to Thomas. And here's something else. Some kid actually drew Boko. Yeah. Being a classic series fan, that is quite impressive, you know. So, yeah, like, some child actually liked Boko as a character. Yeah. Who would have thought? So, looks like Boko, if that's not enough to convince Mattel, you know, how popular classic series characters are, I don't know what will. And seeing that we're now in 2017, I really hope Boko is reintroduced soon. Alright. Others, now, this doesn't really include anything Thomas-related. No, in fact, it actually includes, British Railways, like, Diesel Electric, I think? Yeah, the local commuter, excuse me. The local commuter train is running along through the cold snow. The train is driven by electricity from the third rail. Point to the railroad tracks. Yeah. And it was, oh, here it is. And it was done in 2000. other things that you would also see is a match game, like one of the I Spies, where you could spy what's different. Like, you gotta look at the pictures and see what's wrong in the picture. And oh, and yes, the picture, of course, is from the episode Thomas and Percy's Christmas Adventure, or as we would know, Mountain Adventure. Why did they have to change it to Thanksgiving? Oh, yeah, because of Shining. Did they really? Okay, so here we got. Oh, sorry. Here we have a picture of Donald. And here they also, like, as you can see, like, I circled some of the, like, mistakes in with a pencil. And they also, like, state the mistakes right down here. You just look at them. Yeah, like, kids are not gonna realize that. Kids, yeah, you don't have to put the answers now that I think about it, 'cause kids are much smarter than that. Yeah, they're gonna, realize the obvious, say, like, Donald's nameplate is green, and, like, this house is cream-colored when this one has. Yeah, they're obviously gonna realize. Though I give credit, 'cause you could definitely see this was done with, say, the likes of Photoshop. Oh, and before this does close, we also get, like, another, like, little magazine story. And this one, of course, is another one involving Diesel. In this case, where he shares a story now with Percy rather than Thomas. And the fact that, well, let's see, Diesel is telling Percy that he is too small and too old-fashioned. Yeah, what else is new? One day he thinks he can need to go through the ice that had been iced up. My God, seriously? Iced up? And Percy, yeah, and apparently Percy could squeeze through by actually, like, like, yeah, and there's some more obvious kids' questions and such. Yeah, like, Percy can go through. Yeah, but wait, but that's just strange. Wouldn't workmen, need to, like, hack that, the ice away with, say, some pickaxes and such? And yeah, like, Percy just going under there and, like, actually passing. Come on! Like, the workmen could easily cut that down. Really? All right, and here's some other, like, obvious stuff. Here we have cold engines. It has been snowing heavily all night, and the engines would have to work. And here's one, with special funnel with Peter Sam. So yeah, this is, of course, is referencing the time when Peter Sam's point to Peter Sam's. It's obviously there. What color is Thomas's? Obvious. Yeah, many of the stuff is obvious, but I do like the screen caps that they got too. Oh, and here's another, a coloring one with Percy, and some more, stuff. I guess if you're a child, like, yeah, like, through the eyes of a child, it will be fun, but through the eyes of an adult, yeah, you're gonna find these questions pretty obvious. That's for sure. And here it also says, the next issue is due to arrive March 2001. Wow. And here's a link to the website, thomasthetankengine.com. Yes, I'm glad that they actually say that. Back when it was just Thomas the Tank Engine, not Thomas and Friends. In fact, it does say that right here, but Thomas the Tank Engine really sounds more popular, if you know what I mean. All right, now this one is going to be all about delays. Bear with me, because it's going to be the same thing all over again, yes. So yeah, here's the exact same thing you've seen, from the last, just a little differently. This one, of course, as it's stated, is about delays, and all right, Thomas the Tank Engine was at the platform waiting to pull his coaches Annie and Claire. Well, yeah. And I don't know, the story's kind of like Thomas and the Guard, but probably a little different, just with. Now it's. Well, actually, yeah, I have your guard. Oh, hold on, let me just read the story for a second, just, to make a little comparison. Well, actually, yes, the story is actually loosely based on Thomas and the Guard, just with Thomas leaving his guard behind, but now a passenger gets pissed that, a briefcase got left behind. Okay, and it says, everyone know this is a very good railroad cry. Yeah, the stories are pretty childish, but what'd you expect? But they are quite rare, that's for sure. I'm pretty sure that the and of course, this coming, sorry, seeing that this was, you know, back in the 2000s era, you know, which is at the time when soccer moms, you know, really just could not learn to lighten up. Yeah, because I'm pretty sure that the magazine stories from the 80s and 90s were, you know, a lot more, you know, close with railway accuracy, I suppose. Yeah, here's the same thing. It's nothing new, just new questions and such. And here's another one from Thomas Percy and... Oh, sorry, Thomas Percy's Chris... Yeah, this is kind of like the other one, you know, with Donald, as you saw in the last magazine. Just now it's with a shot with Thomas and Percy, because it's also asking the same thing, you know, what's different. And, man, did they really have to do that? I mean, you're going to spoil everything. Then again, even as a kid, I had a hard time figuring out a bit, maybe. So, yeah, there is some... It says circle things that have a delay. Yeah, what else is new? Alright, here is delayed engines. We have more screen caps. I think they're mostly from the same... Well, most of them are from Season 3 with the mountain... the Christmas adventure. And I'm sure the same thing again with Terrence in the background. We also have Thomas Gets Bumped with Birdie. And we even have the passengers from A Scarf for Percy. Or, as we would know, Percy in the Trousers. And here we have another poster. Alright, let me just try and... Oh, yes, I forgot I ripped this one apart. This one is from No Joke for James, as you can see right here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's from No Joke for James. I could be wrong. No, actually, I'm sure of it, yeah. Remember, I actually ripped this, like, the little workbook out. I'll just show you this for a quick second, so yeah. Draw the lines that can... that connect to a matching object. Yeah, it's the same... Yeah, because this is, you know, about anything or everything that runs late. Late engines. Or this picture of Thomas and Percy. Yeah. Oh, and I even ripped part of the book. Oh, and here's another draw one instead. This time now we have Henry. Yeah, this is how I drew Henry when I was... Again, I was a kid. I really didn't know how to draw better back then. But yeah, here's the same thing. Nothing new. Okay, Alright, here we also have... here it is. It's called Preschool Playroom. It just features stories from, those I mentioned earlier. I'm not going to go through it again. But yeah, here is the rest. Another Connect the Dots. And this time it's the... Yeah, they really made the Connect the Dots so obvious, didn't they? The Long Delay. Yeah. Thomas, Gordon, and Percy, yeah. Percy, James, and Edward. Follow the lines to see who's delayed, and wouldn't you know it, Edward's late. Yeah. Yeah, like, pretty unlikely for an old engine like... Wait, Edward did run late in the series before. It seems like I made a few spelling errors. And here's more of this, and... Oh, and look at this obvious question. Which engine, like, which word and which, you know, engine, you know, have the same letter, and it's delay, and we got duck. Yeah, so much for the Great Western way. Alright, same checklist. Excuse me for a second. Alright, and here is, of course, more fan art. Alright, so yeah, here is the most of the fan art that we got to see. Oh, and something else I forgot to show is this. The sender of each picture on this page will receive this wonderful Thomas carrying case, which, of course, is for the Urdle models. Yeah, like, the Urdle models have this carrying case in the shape of Thomas, as you can see right here. Okay, and here's some of the fan art. Jolly James, Duck Bills. Oh, and yes, there's, of course, fans for Duck. Never mind the fact that Duck is, of course, back in the series ever since season 7. Oh, yeah, and this is a picture of Gordon right over here. Yeah, like he's supposed to look like some big blue caterpillar or something. Man, but then again, these are children. They really wouldn't know better yet. But here's some fan art for Thomas and the Magic Railroad when it came out. So, this was back when kids liked it, you know. Of course, before they'd grow up and, you know, hate the movie like I do. So, yeah, and oh, and here's a kid. Yeah, it even shows kids in Halloween costumes. Yeah, and look at this. A kid, you know, dressed as Thomas. Cute. Alright, here's another coloring one with Percy and Thomas with a... let's just move along. And here's another delay story involving Henry pulling the flying kipper. Well, at least they got that notion, because that's something Henry does best. Yeah, like, he's delayed and the fish are starting to stink. So, yeah, more obvious questions. Then we have, I don't know what else there is, but yeah, here's another one. Trains on time. More obvious questions, as you could see right here. Oh, and look at this. These are also schedules for the Day Out with Thomas and Friends events back in 2001. Yes, in September 15th to 23rd. Yeah. Almost before the time of, you know what. Yeah. Rest in peace to all those who passed away and man, that was one of the worst times in our lives. But yes, these are all schedules for the Day Out with Thomas and Friends events that would come out in 2001. And enjoy Thomas and Friends, you know, as they were popular. And oh yeah, and these of course are just other objects, nothing connected to the series, just different objects, and you just gotta write the name in. Wait a second. This I never really like seen before. Make a word underneath each picture. Write the letter that begins with the. Oh, I never really noticed this. They're all like it's an anag. No, it's not. It's more or less like a code, like to dis mostly describing which, you know, objects, you know, the letters that they each start with, and what they would spell if you use the first letter. Tent, hat, orange, mouse, apple, and sock. Thomas. Yes, Thomas. That's what it spells, yeah. And here's another picture as well. Nothing else new. And here's the next one. Available in May, and of course, as you could see again, 2001. So, yeah, these are the Thomas magazines that I own so far in a nutshell. Oh, excuse me for a second. Okay, so these are the Tom. Excuse me. These are the Thomas the Tank. Excuse me. The Thomas the Tank Engine magazines in a nutshell. And I know, yes, that plenty of these questions were, well, pretty obvious, you know, especially for something that was aimed, you know, at, you know, really, you know, at toddlers and, excuse me, at toddlers and such, and, well, younger, like, preteens that would be, like, say, in, like, say, 8 or 9 years, yeah, but nonetheless, they're pretty interesting, and very, very rare for those, you know, who love Thomas the Tank Engine, like I do. Yeah, you can make your own opinions, but I'm pretty sure that the ones that came out in the 80s and the 90s would probably be a lot more fun. But if you're really looking, see, but if you're really interested, well, all I could say is good luck finding them. That's all I'm gonna tell you right now. Like, good luck finding these things, because granted, I don't know, you know, if like the same magazine shop would still sell, you know, the ones from the past. Probably, it's yeah. I don't know. I wouldn't exactly know, but I'm pretty sure. You know what? I'm actually quite skeptical. Maybe they would. Maybe they wouldn't. It's just a false hope, I guess. But let me guys know, what do you guys think? And again, good luck finding these things if you ever got the chance. I don't really pay attention for these things, but I'm pretty sure they may sell them on, you know, well, online retailing sites like, say, eBay, probably. I'm pretty sure eBay. You know, I never really checked that much for these things online. But if you're really interested, well, have fun. And you may actually, you know, get a kick out of them, despite how obvious the questions really are. So until then, this is Mike D57S signing off, and we'll see you guys again next time. Goodbye.